สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Hot Thai Kitchen. Now I'm pretty sure most of you know what a tom yum soup is. It's one of Thailand's most popular dishes. Now there are hundreds of variations of tom yum. I already have two on my website, but today I'm adding a third. I am making tom yum het mang sawirat. Now het is mushrooms and mang sawirat is vegetarian or vegan. Now when I developed this recipe, it turned out to be a bit more of a challenge than I thought it would be because traditional tom yum relies so heavily on the flavor of fish sauce and also animal-based broth. So after a few trials and error, I finally arrived at this recipe, which I have to say is phenomenal. I'm a meat eater and I loved it. So if you're vegetarian or vegan, or you've got friends who are vegetarian or vegan, this is a recipe that'll satisfy everybody. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with making the vegetable stock that we're gonna use as a base for the soup, okay? So I've got here some daikon radish, which is very commonly used in a Thai broth or stock. I've got some onion. I've got some cilantro roots, which I have smashed. And I've also got some cracked white pepper right here and some smashed garlic. One of the versions that I made, I put carrots in my stock and it just tasted too much like carrots. So all of the vegetables we're using here, it's mild enough that it's going to give off a nice flavor that won't be overpowering. And do not be tempted to just use water for this, okay? I've done it and it is highly, highly disappointing. It's a brothy soup, so if you just use water, the flavor will be so weak. I mean, if you were making like a creamy soup that's vegan, you can get away with water as a liquid, but not in this case, okay? So we're gonna let this go for about an hour. So the herbs we are using are the same, what I call tom yum trinity. We've got some lemongrass, and I'm using quite a bit because in tom yum, I do want the flavor for the lemongrass to lead. And all you do is just smash the lemongrass with something heavy. You can use the back of your knife, and then just cut them into big chunks, okay? And I only use the bottom half because that's where the flavor is most concentrated. The top half I save for stock and tea and things like that. I've got some galangal, and today I've got a whole one to show you. It looks kind of like this. You don't need to peel it, you just need to slice it up into thin rounds. And the last of the trinity, kaffir lime leaves, wonderful citrusy aroma, so important in this dish. They also sell these dry or frozen, by the way, so you might want to check those departments. For this, I am adding some grilled shallots. So these are just shallots that I shouldn't say grilled, broiled. So I just put them under the broiler in the oven for a few minutes until they're charred. And I think it's important for a vegetarian tom yum because it really does add a little extra smokiness and body and richness to the broth. Mushrooms. So you can use whatever kind of mushrooms you like, although I stick with Asian mushrooms, you know, just keeping with the theme here. So I've got some oyster mushrooms here, which I love for tom yum soup. And I've also got some enoki mushrooms here. And these are really popular in Asia for hot pots and soups. And I like them here because they look kind of like noodles in the soup at the end. And then some fresh shiitake mushrooms that I've sliced. The only mushrooms I will suggest you don't use is the button mushrooms. They're not great in soups. They're kind of spongy and they don't really integrate into the soup. So, you know, save those for something else. All right, let's get cooking. All right, so here's our vegetable stock. It smells fantastic, smells very Thai. I fished out all the vegetables with just a mesh skimmer, and you should have about 3 cups at this point. If you don't, add a little more water. If you have too much, just let it reduce a little more. No big deal. Okay, so now I'm gonna switch pot. This is my soup pot. I'm gonna turn on the heat, just on, you know, medium. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of oil. And now to this oil, I'm going to add some chili flakes. That's right, you can use whatever kind of chili flakes you want. The chili flakes will infuse into the oil and then it'll give a nice red color. Another reason why I'm adding a little oil is because without the bone broth, this soup is entirely lean. There's zero drop of fat in it. And it's not quite as nice in terms of mouthfeel and richness when it's too lean like that. Okay, so now it's a little toasty. The oil is nice and red. I'm gonna go in with my broth. And you can see already how that chili oil is making that broth look nice. Otherwise, it would just look like plain broth. It's not as nice. Okay, so all the herbs are gonna go in. So the kaffir lime leaves, you want to make sure you give it some rough love before you throw it in. So really twist and bruise it. It'll just help the flavors come out a little better. All these herbs that I just put in, you're not supposed to eat, okay? That's just for infusion purposes only. The shallots though, we're gonna leave them in there because you can eat those. They become really sweet. And they only need to simmer for about 3 minutes. It's not like a cinnamon stick that takes a long time. It's very quick, okay? Oh, while this is boiling, I'll tell you about something I forgot to tell you about earlier. If you like something crunchy in your soup, try looking for these black fungus mushrooms. I know that does not sound appetizing at all, but they're sometimes called black fungus, cloud ear mushroom. There's like a few other names I don't remember right now, but these are dried and they're quite widely available at Chinese grocery stores. And you soak these in water, just in hot water or room temperature water. Hot water will be faster. And they don't have much of a flavor, but they've got this nice crunch to it. And then you can add this to your soup as well. So that's an option if you want. We can really smell the herbs in the air, and the chilies are also in the air. There's a bit of coughing going on. That's what happens when you're in Hot Thai Kitchen. All right, I'm gonna add the mushrooms. If you wanna remove some of the herbs now, do it now, okay? Throw away your herbs. All right, so all the mushrooms are going in, and all of these only take 1 minute to cook. Ooh, that looks pretty. I'm gonna season this. Normally I'd use fish sauce, but of course, we're instead going to use soy sauce, and this is Thai mushroom soy sauce. But if you want, you can just use regular soy sauce. Just a little bit of sugar, just to balance out that salt. So I'm gonna just bring this to a boil. All right, the soup is boiling, the mushrooms are cooked through. I'm gonna turn this off now. And then I'm gonna throw in some tomatoes. And I'm using cherry tomatoes. You can use large tomatoes and then just cut them into small wedges. And I throw them in sort of at the end, because I don't want them to be mushy and then, you know, the skin starts floating off of the tomato. But the tomatoes, especially when they're ripe and sweet like these, will add that sort of burst of juicy fruitiness that works really, really well in tom yum. My lime juice, the most important seasoning. Fresh, fresh, fresh always. Don't use bottled lime juice, please. Whenever you make soup, you always want to taste and adjust the seasoning because you don't know how much things have evaporated and all that stuff. Oh, oh, that's good. It's like I surprise myself every time I taste it. That just looks so good. Little cilantro, chopped cilantro. If you want, you can also do sawtooth coriander. We do that a lot in tom yum as well. Or if you're one of those cilantro haters, you don't have to put any in. Mm. Oh my God. As a meat eater, I would never have guessed this was vegan. So if you've got friends who think, oh, vegan food's gross, whatever, you feed them this and it'll change their mind forever. They've completely lost their right to say anything bad about vegan food. It's so flavorful. All the herbs really come out. It's tart from that lime juice, but well balanced by both the little bit of sugar and the sweetness of the tomatoes, and also just the natural sweetness of the vegetables that we use in the stocks. And this is why it's so important that you use a good vegetable stock. All that natural sweetness really gives this some body and some richness, but at the same time, it's really light and so refreshing. Oh my God, so good. So I hope you give this a try. The recipe, as always, is on hotthaikitchen.com. When you make it, send me a photo on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and I will see you next time for your next delicious Thai meal.